Hi friends, I am Saitech and welcome back to my channel Saitech. In today's we'll try to do the 4G plus comparison between IQ7, OnePlus 9R, Mi 11X device and the Realme X7 Max device. So by using the Jio SIM card, I'll try to use the same Jio SIM card in all of the four smartphones, and in this way we'll be able to get to know which phone has got the what kind of signals. And this is the test which I'm trying to do using the 4G plus signals. So there's another video which I uploaded without using 4G plus, but this video is particularly designed for the 4G plus. So all the smartphones right now and Jio SIM in this location supports the 4G plus aggregation. So one quick note before starting the video, friends. So one thing is that the speed depends upon the SIM card and depends upon the location you are in. So right now in the metropolitan city, you may experience really high speeds. In the normal towns, you will be experiencing really low speeds. But let's see, friends, using the Jio SIM card, let's see whether the Realme X1 Max can get how much kind of speed. So that is what I'll try to concentrate first. So let's see with the Realme X1 Max, and then I'll try to use in one by one phone. I'll try to do the testing two times in each phone. So make sure to hit that subscribe and do support me, friends, and don't forget to check the links in description for more details. And right now you can see clearly 4G plus it's displaying on the screen. As you can see, friends, 4G plus. So 4G plus is right now, you can see clearly. And using the RX monitor application as well, RX monitor application, you can see the 2CA aggregation. So let me try to start the test right now. Let's see how much the speeds we can get in this Realme X1 Max using 4G plus Jio SIM card. So right now in my location, as you can see, friends, the speeds, how much I'm getting right now in my location, the speeds are close to 17 and 19 Mbps and 20 Mbps at this point using the 4G plus. I'll try to use the same SIM in other phones at same location, same time, so we'll be able to see which phone can actually detect more signals at this point of doing the recording. That is what I'm trying to say. So maybe in your location, if you're using different SIM card, you may be experiencing really high speeds, but right now let's see, friends, how much speeds we'll be getting here. So I'm trying to do the test two times. In two times I'll try to take one maximum recorded speed. So right now in the Realme X1 Max, the speeds are increasing 16 19 20 23 25 25, as you can see 26 in the Realme X1 Max using 4G plus Jio SIM, 35, oh my god, 36, as you can see, friends, 36 Mbps. So now let's compare with other smartphones whether they will be able to beat the Realme X1 Max or not. So you can see the all other phones, there is no SIM card in any smartphone. So that is the reason I did open the SIM card and I did keep it outside, so you know exactly I'm trying to use the same SIM card in all the smartphones. So now let me try to quickly remove the SIM card from the Realme X1 Max, and then I'll try to select in the other smartphones. So I got used to the SIM card tray in the bottom, and this is a sideways the SIM card, as you can see. So and that's the one difference in the Realme X1 Max. So now let's see in the Mi 11X device. I think because of the 3.5mm jack, the slot moved to the left side. So now I'm trying to use in the Mi 11X device. So let's see in the Mi 11X device whether this phone able to keep up this kind of high speeds or not using the same SIM card. So you can quickly see on the notification 4G plus is displaying currently, as you can see. Let me try to use a couple of other applications to test whether 4G plus in the Netmonster application. In the Netmonster application, sometimes it won't be visible the LTE, but right now only 4G you are seeing. That's no problem, friends, because on the notification you can clearly see the 4G plus. That should not be a big issue. So let's see how much speeds the Mi 11X can actually get in this phone. That is the most interesting thing. Let's see how much. And make sure to check the links in description in case if you're planning to buy any of the products, you can use my links and that will be really helpful to support me. And right now the speeds I'm getting in the Mi 11X device is of 15 16 Mbps, 17 and 20 Mbps, 22 Mbps. As you can see, friends, 22 Mbps I got the speed in the Mi 11X device, not bad. So when compared with the Realme X1 Max device, so it's kind of close to Realme X1 Max for the first time testing. So let's see the second time testing whether that will be higher or not. That is another really interesting thing to check right now. And let me try to do the second time testing. And after doing second time testing, I'm experiencing a little bit kind of less speeds. As I said, this speed also depends upon the type of location and type of SIM you're using. So let's see in my location, using my SIM, which phone will be able to grab most of the signals. And the highest in the Realme Exynos Max recorded right now 36 Mbps. I'm trying to do the test only two times because I just want to keep this complete video really short. That is the reason I'm trying to do the test two times only. So as soon as the test finishes, I'll try to remove the SIM card. So let me try to remove the SIM card from the Mi 11X and try to use in the OnePlus 9R. So let's see how much the OnePlus 9R speed we can get in the OnePlus mobile phones. So all these four smartphones are really good in terms of the connectivity, friends. There's not much difference you can actually experience between the phones. So all phones support the Wi-Fi 6 and same kind of speeds you are getting. And right now let's see whether OnePlus 9R will be able to display 4G plus aggregation or not on the top. Yes, we got the 4G plus successfully, there is no problem. And let me try to use the RX monitor application. And using the RX monitor application, you can see the 2CA perfectly alright. So carrier aggregation is supported. And let's test the speed, how much speed we can actually get in this OnePlus 9R device. That's a really interesting thing to test in this phone. So right now I'm getting about 23. Oh, that's good. The first minute itself, it went up to 23, 24, 25, 6, and again it decreased slightly. So let's see what will be the highest score so far. And right now we got about 20 Mbps, not so much, but still it's kind of okay. So after this video, I'll try to do the CPU throttling test comparison, friends. So make sure to stay tuned for that video, CPU throttling and the 3D benchmark test as well. So make sure to stay tuned for those videos in case if you're interested to know. Comparing all the smartphones, that is what I'm planning to do right now. And I'm trying to do the test second time. So sometimes it takes couple of seconds to detect the server. So let me try to cancel and try again. So let's see, friends, in the second time testing, will it be able to cross the Realme Exynos Max or not? That is what I'm trying to see. So till now the first position is a Realme Exynos Max Mi 11X device. Now OnePlus 9R, I think so. So it's right now I'm getting about 4G plus successfully and speeds, yes, 24, 24, 25. Can it cross 30? So I think 24. I think it will stop around 24 Mbps. So 24 Mbps is the speed we got in the OnePlus 9R device successfully. And right now the second position goes to the OnePlus 9R, and first is a Realme Exynos Max, and third is the Mi 11X device. So final phone which we are all waiting for, the IQ7 device. So let's see what will happen in the IQ7, whether the IQ7 gonna perform really well or not. So even the IQ7 has got the 4G plus support, but not everywhere inside your house. Only the indoor condition is not good in the IQ7 in terms of the connectivity, friends. So maybe if you are living in the metropolitan city, you won't notice at all, but normal towns and normal cities, then definitely you will be able to see some kind of disturbance in terms of the 4G plus and 4G in the IQ7 device. So right now, as soon as you turned on, as you can see the 4G plus right now I'm getting it successfully. So no issues in terms of the 4G plus. So now let me try to open the Netmonster application and show you the results. Here it's not showing, no problem, try different application, because sometimes Netmonster application won't show for some other reason. And right now I'm trying to use the RX monitor application, and here it's showing 2CA, so aggregation is supported. So now let's test what will be the speeds in the IQ7 device. So let's see whether this will beat or not. So right now the speeds are kind of really low when compared with other smartphones. That's a really shocking thing. So as I said, the speeds depends upon time to time and type of SIM to SIM and location to location, friends. But overall you need to consider that all the phones supports the 4G plus without any problem. That is what you can come into the conclusion. So right now in my phone, I'm getting the 4G plus successfully, no issues. And upload speeds are slightly less when compared with other smartphones. But let's try the second time. Second time, let's see whether it will be change. It will be any kind of change or not. And second time, I'm getting 18 Mbps of speeds, 18, but it's not going above 18 Mbps. That's it, not much. as you can see, friends. So overall, the highest speed first goes to Realme X1 Max, second price close to OnePlus 9R, third Mi 11X device, and fourth IQ7 device in terms of the speeds what I got right now. So this doesn't mean that IQ7 is completely slow. You will be getting really high speeds in the IQ7, but it depends upon the location and type of SIM you are using. So in my location, these are the results which I found in all the four smartphones. So even sometimes I did see the IQ7 getting about 30 Mbps and 25 Mbps, but sometimes it's like this. So this is a quick comparison, friends, between all of these four smartphones. And in case if you want more comparison, stay tuned for upcoming videos. So you'll definitely like that, and don't forget to comment below and check the links in description for the live wallpapers what I'm using. So see you in the next video, friends.